A related rates problem is an application of calculus to a physical situation where we have multiple quantities that depend on each other or on time, and we need to find a relation between their derivatives. Here's an example of a related rates problem. A prisoner is trying to escape at night. He runs in a straight line towards the wall of the prison. A guard points a spotlight at the prisoner. The spotlight is on the ground, 30 meters away from the wall. The prisoner is 1.8 meters tall and weighs 85 kilograms. How fast is the height of the shadow on the wall changing when the prisoner is 20 meters away from the wall and running at 8 meters per second? I invite you to pause the video and try to solve this problem. Even if you cannot fully solve it, if you spend some time trying to understand the statement, drawing a picture, understanding what it is asking, and getting started, my explanation will be much more useful. First, we need to model the problem. That is, we will take the word problem and transform it into a math question. I'll begin by drawing a picture. Let's say that this is the ground, and here is the wall. The prisoner is running towards the wall, so let's put the prisoner maybe here, and the spotlight is here. Now the light is pointing towards the prisoner, and then it's producing a shadow on the wall. So all of this is going to be the shadow. Now let's take the data from the statement of the problem and add it to the picture. First, we know that the distance between the light and the wall is 30 meters. I'm going to call this A. And we know that A is 30 meters. And we also know the height of the prisoner. I'm going to call it H. H is 1.8 meters. So this is not at scale. And I know that these two quantities are constant. They don't depend on time. But I do have a few other quantities that depend on time. As the prisoner is running, the position of the prisoner is going to change, and the height of the shadow is going to change as well. In fact, as the prisoner gets closer to the wall, I expect the height of the shadow to decrease, to become smaller. So let's give names to these two things. I'm going to call the height of the shadow, which is this, y, and I'm going to call the position of the prisoner x. And what I know is that x and y depend on time. Now, what do we want to compute? We want to find out how fast is the height of the shadow on the wall changing. That is, what I want is the derivative of y with respect to t, with respect to time. And I want to find this at a moment when, let's see what's the data I have, when the prisoner is 20 meters away from the wall. So the distance from the prisoner to the wall is 20 meters. But since A was 30 meters, that means that x is 10 meters. So at a time when x is 10 meters, and the prisoner is running at 8 meters per second, the velocity of the prisoner is the derivative of its position. So that is dx with respect to t is 8 meters per second. Now, I need a relation between the derivative of y and the derivative of x. I can get one if I first get a relation between y and x. And luckily I can do that, because I notice that here I have two right triangles that are, well, similar. I have the triangle with height h and base x, and then I also have the triangle with height y and base a, and they are similar. So by similar triangles, I can get the equation that says that h over x is going to be equal to y over a. And that completes the setup. I have finished the modeling part. I have everything I need. I figure out which quantities were constant, which quantities depended on time, what is it that I'm looking for, and the data I have, and finally, the relation between all the variables. The rest is calculations. Now that the problem is modeled, we can pretty much forget where it came from and solve the new calculus question by taking derivatives. I have a relation between x and y, and I want a relation between their derivatives. I will obtain that by differentiating this equation implicitly with respect to time. So let's do that. Here's the equation, and the derivative of the left-hand side is going to be equal to the derivative of the right-hand side. Now remember that in this problem, h is a constant, so it comes out, and I need the derivative of 1 over x using the chain rule, that is minus 1 over x squared times its derivative with respect to time. On the other side, a is a constant, it comes out, and I'm left simply with dy dt. And now I can solve for the quantity I was looking for, which is dy over dt. And that comes out to be minus ah over x squared times dx dt. So now let's see if I have all the variables to substitute in here. I know the values of a and h, they're constant. And at the instant I care about, I know the value of the function x and its derivative. So let's go ahead and substitute. This is going to be equal to minus a is 30 meters, h is 1.8 meters, x is 10 meters squared, and the derivative of x with respect to time is 8 meters per second. And now simply do the computation, and this computation comes out to be minus 4.32 meters per second, which is my final answer. This is the rate of change of the height of the shadow on the wall with respect to time. Notice that it is negative. That means that the height of the shadow is decreasing, as I had predicted. So I guess that is a good sign, pun intended.